I say, surely the darkness will cover me, and the light around me turn to night. Darkness is not dark to you, Lord. The night is as bright as the day. Darkness and light to you are both alike.
For God makes speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Psalm 68.
Let God arise, and let his enemies be scattered. Let those who hate him flee before him.
Let them vanish like smoke when the wind drives it away. As the wax melts at the fire, so let the wicked perish at the presence of God.
But let the righteous be glad and rejoice before God. Let them also be merry and joyful.
Sing to God, sing praises to his name. Exalt him who rides upon the heavens. Yahweh is his name. Rejoice before him.
Father of orphans, defender of widows. God in his holy habitation.
God gives the solitary a home and brings forth prisoners into freedom. But the rebel shall live in dry places.
O God, when you went forth before your people, when you marched through the wilderness,
the earth shook and the skies poured down rain. At the presence of God, the God of Sinek. At the presence of God, the God of Israel.
You sent a gracious rain, O God, upon your inheritance. You refreshed the land when it was weary.
Your people found their home in you. In your goodness, O God, you have made provision for the poor.
The Lord gave the word, and great was the company of women who bore the tidings.
Kings with their armies are fleeing away. The women at home are dividing the spoil.
Though you lingered among the sheepfolds, you shall be like a dove whose wings are covered with silver, whose feathers are like green gold.
When the Almighty scattered kings, it was like snow falling in Zalmon.
O mighty mountain, a hill of Bashan, O rugged mountain, O hill of Bashan.
Why do you look with envy, O rugged mountain, at the hill which God chose for his resting place? Truly, the Lord will dwell there forever.
The chariots of God are 20,000, even thousands of thousands. The Lord comes in holiness from Sinai.
You have gone up on high and led captivity captive. You have received gifts even from your enemies, that the Lord God might dwell among them.
Blessed be the Lord day by day, the God of our salvation, who bears our burdens.
He is our God, the God of our with the congregation. Bless the Lord, you that are of the fountain of Israel.
There is Benjamin, least of the tribes at the head, the princes of Judah in our company, and the princes of Zebulun and Naphtali.
Send forth your strength, O God. Establish, O God, what you have wrought for us.
Kings shall bring gifts to you. For your temple's sake at Jerusalem,
rebuke the wild beasts of the reeds and the peoples, the herd of wanderers with its calves.
Trample down those who lust after silver. Scatter the peoples glad delighting war.
Let tribute be brought out of Egypt. Let Ethiopia stretch out her hands to God.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the sing praises to the Lord.
He rides in the heavens, the ancient heavens. He sends forth his voice, his mighty voice.
Ascribe power to God. His majesty is over Israel. His strength is in the sky.
How wonderful is God in his holy places. The God of Israel giving strength and power to his people. Blessed be God.
Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The book of Genesis, the 21st chapter, beginning at the first verse. The Lord dealt with Sarah as he had said, and the Lord did for Sarah as he had promised. Sarah conceived and bore Abraham a son in old age, at the time of which God had spoken to him. Abraham gave the name Isaac to his son, whom Sarah bore him. And Abraham circumcised his son Isaac when he was 8 days old, as God had commanded him. Abraham was 100 years old when his son Isaac was born to him. Now Sarah said, God has brought laughter for me. Everyone who hears will laugh with me. And she said, who would ever have said to Sarah, to Abraham, that Sarah would nurse children? Yet I have borne him a son in his old age. The child grew and was weaned, and Abraham made a great feast on the day that Isaac was weaned. But Sarah saw the son of Hagar the Egyptian, whom she had borne to Abraham, playing with her son Isaac. So she said to Abraham, cast out this slave woman with her son, for the son of this slave woman shall not inherit along with my son Isaac. The matter was very distressing to Abraham on account of his son. But God said to Abraham, do not be distressed because of the boy and because of your slave woman. Whatever Sarah says to you, do as she tells you, for it is through Isaac that offspring shall be named for you. As for the son of the slave woman, I will make a nation of him also, because he is your offspring. So Abraham rose early in the morning, and took bread and a skin of water, and gave it to Hagar, putting it on her shoulder, along with the child, and sent her away. And she departed and wandered about in the wilderness of Beersheba. When the water in the skin was gone, she cast the child under one of the bushes. Then she went and sat down opposite him a good way off, about the distance of a bow shot, for she said, do not let me look on the death of the child. And as she sat opposite him, she lifted up her voice and wept. And God heard the voice of the boy. And the angel of God called to Hagar from heaven and said to her, what troubles you, Hagar? Do not be afraid, for God has heard the voice of the boy where he is. Come, lift up the boy and hold him fast with your hand, for I will make a great nation. Then God opened her eyes, and she saw a well of water. She went and filled the skin with water, and gave the boy a drink. he grew up. He lived in the wilderness and became an expert with the bow. He lived in the wilderness of Paran, and his mother got a wife for him from the land of Egypt. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Domine,
salva.
Mark, the 8th chapter, beginning of the 1st verse. In those days, when there was again a great crowd without anything to eat, he called his disciples and said to them, I have compassion for the crowd, because they have been with me now for 3 days and have nothing to eat. If I send them away hungry to their homes, they will faint in the way, and some of them have come from a great distance. His disciples replied, how can one feed these people with bread here in the desert? He asked them, how many loaves do you have? And they said, 7. Then he ordered the crowd to sit down on the ground, and he took the 7 loaves, and after giving thanks he broke them and gave them to his disciples to distribute, and they distributed them to the crowd. They had also a few small fish, and after blessing them he ordered that these 2 should be distributed. They ate and were filled, and they took up broken pieces left over, 7 baskets full. Now there were about 4,000 people, and he sent them away, and immediately he got into the boat with his disciples and went to the district. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, you who now have set your servant free to go in peace as you have promised, all these eyes of mine have seen the Savior, whom you have prepared for all the world to see. Light to enlighten the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory to the Father and to the Son and and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray.
Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Show us your mercy, O Lord,
and grant us your salvation.
Clothe your ministers with righteousness.
Let your people sing with joy.
Give peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For only in you can we live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care.
And guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon earth.
Your saving health among all nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten.
Nor the hope of the poor be taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God,
and sustain us with your Holy Spirit.
Almighty and everlasting God, you govern all things, both in heaven and on earth. Mercifully hear the supplications of your people, and in our time grant us your peace. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Most holy God, the source of all good desires, all right judgments, and all just works, give to us your servants that peace which the world cannot give, so that our minds may be fixed in the doing of your will, and that we, being delivered from the fear of our enemies, may live in peace and quietness. Through the mercies of Christ Jesus, our Saviour.
Amen.
Be our light in the darkness, O Lord, and in your great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of your only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Lord Jesus, stay with us. Evening is at hand and the day is past. Be our companion in the way, kindle our hearts, and awaken hope, that we may know you as you are revealed in Scripture and the breaking of bread. Grant this for the sake of your life.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing, through the power of the Holy Spirit.